news tonight in Newton County, where the public safety department is now saying, in regards to a missing persons case, a person's body has been found inside that wrecked vehicle along I-20. Now, this is in relation to the missing mother, Yolanda Brown from Covington. They have not said this body was hers, just that a body was found. We'll, of course, continue to follow this and keep you updated on 11alive.com and inside our 11alive news app.
Okay, so that is the gist of what's going on right now. Let me give you pretty much the rest of what's going on. So at this point, along Highway I-20, they were able to use pinging cell phone activity to locate her vehicle. Several law enforcement vehicles lined up around 2:20 p.m. today near the woods off of Interstate 20, as they found a vehicle with similarity to the car that belonged to Yolanda Brown, who was the mother missing from Covington, Georgia. The vehicle has some similarities to Yolanda's vehicle, said Sergeant Jack Rellinger, and he is from the Newton County Sheriff's Office. The GBI is also on scene to recover the body. So we're currently in the investigative stages now to see if this is the same vehicle. Deputies located the car from the ping from the cell phone towers, as I said earlier. We started a couple days ago working eastbound and then working westbound as we located the vehicle today. GSP did not say if the body was Brown, but said the driver was found dead. Georgia Department of Transportation shut down one westbound lane ahead of rush hour as authorities investigated near exit 92, not far from Brown's residence. Georgia Bureau of Investigation agents went to the scene. The car will be taken to their headquarters. Now, Brown had been seen leaving the parking lot at the Irish Bread Pub along Virginia Avenue in Hapeville, Georgia, which is on the south side of the perimeter of Atlanta, Georgia. In the early morning hours of Saturday, September 3rd, Hapeville police said their agency was contacted September 3rd regarding Brown's disappearance. However, police, through witness statements and surveillance video, they were able to determine Brown left Hapeville on her own accord. Joshua Doughty, who lives with his mom, said she never made it back to their home in Covington, which is about a 40-minute drive. She never came home, never. The son added his mom's phone pinged in the Covington area of Newton County at one point. Hapeville police initially said they had found facts that placed her in her home county of Newton County. Brown's family had believed she met someone at the pub and that something bad had happened to her. She doesn't meet strangers. She always wants to be someone's friend, Brown's sister, Mickey Natal, said last week. I am 100% convinced that her friend-making is what led to her being missing right now. It is quite disturbing. It's quite telling as far as what their relationship was. I didn't see much grieving from her, and I don't want to be one that's judgmental in this time of grieving because people grieve in different ways. I made a video about this yesterday about how sometimes relatives lie, and when people are missing and we're looking for them, we're misled because they're not being honest. She was honest in this situation, maybe a little too honest, but, you know, unfortunately, from what the GBI was able to put together and what they were able to find, it is easy to presume that this vehicle is hers and the body inside that is expired is hers. I want to send my condolences to her families, especially her son who had to deal with this ordeal. If there are any updates, I will update you. Have a good day.